Back to the phone lines. We'll talk next to Jared listening on Sirius XM 131 in Kansas. Hi, Jared.
Oh, thanks for taking the call.
You're welcome.
Just curious if any information that you have run across in the Bible that discusses a person's vocation and what a person would do with their life, you know, that Jesus would want them to do. You know, different people are born a certain way. Some of the people are shy. Some people are the complete opposite of that. And obviously, maybe the shy person wouldn't want to be a singer or on TV, but it just seems that somehow there would be some guidance. I didn't know if you had anything about that.
Yeah, well, what you have to do is exercise your gift. And this is what is pointed out by Paul in Romans chapter 12. If a man's gift is prophesying, let him use it in proportion to his faith. If it's serving, let him serve. If it's teaching, let him teach. If it is encouraging, let him encourage. If it's contributing to the needs of others, let him give generously. If it's leadership, let him govern diligently. If it's showing mercy, let him do so cheerfully. You have to exercise your gift, your talent. You will never be responsible for my gift, my talent. I will never be responsible for your gift, your talent. We are responsible to take our time, our treasure, and our talent and use it for God's glory and for the extension of his kingdom. So here's what you do. You follow God's leading, and he leads through circumstances and people, and exercise your gift. And God, who has come to live within you and is your leader and guider, will allow you to discover your gift. He will make it abundantly plain. And he has given you substantial gifts. You have to use them. But you can't use somebody else's gift. You have to use, as is implicit in the prologue to the question, as you've already kind of pointed out, as you've asked the question, you can't do what you're not gifted to do, nor can someone else do what you are gifted to do. Therefore, you have to exercise, again, your gift.
Yeah, I think I've sensed that, and I'm struggling with, especially for the last 10 years in the current location I'm in now and job, is that I'm missing something. I've struggled with this job and knowing that this isn't right. But I've continued to, other opportunities have come along, but just nothing that seems to fit.
Well, remember, there's no safer place than a leap of faith. I mean, sometimes you have to take that leap of faith. Sometimes you're tied to a job because of security. The very fact that you're struggling in a particular vocation may be a sign that this is not the right place for you. Remember Eric Liddell in Chariots of Fire, he had this famous line where he said, "When I run, I sense his pleasure." He said, "God made me fast." And so exercising that gift became a doorway ultimately to other opportunities. But he recognized that what he was really called to do outside of the platform that was established through his running was to be a missionary, and that's where he died in China. Again, God led him through people and circumstances, and ultimately through his word, to find his talent, to use his talent, and to recognize that the use of the talent wasn't just for time, but ultimately was a use of talent for all eternity.